The gaming setup that you see behind us right there is about to change once again. Massive shout out to MSI for, of course, making this video possible and making this upgrade possible by sending over one of their brand new MAG272 CQR monitors that are 165Hz, 1440p, 1 millisecond response time, VA panels. They're absolutely amazing. This is a 27-inch version, the exact same monitor that we have sitting right here, also sent by MSI. And we're going to be adding a second one today to this gaming setup, and the ultra wide is going to go to an entirely different setup that I'll make a video about in the next couple of days or weeks. We'll see what happens. But today's video is all about MSI's brand new monitor and us, of course, upgrading the setup behind us right here. Finally, we're going to have matching monitors and everything should turn out looking absolutely sick, dude. I'm gonna move some things about, which gives me the opportunity to maybe check out some RGB speakers on the channel, as I'm finally gonna have enough space to actually put speakers on either side of the monitors. Yeah, I think this is the way to properly open it. There you go, that's much easier. So here we have the monitor stand. It's all metal, feels cool to the touch. And of course it does come with some rubber pads on the bottom here as well to prevent anything from slipping. Anyway, let's lift this thing up and boom, we have the monitor here and the rest of the stand. Here we have the actual monitor stand, which does support height adjustment and does have a up and down swivel. There's also a cable pass-through hole right here in the stand, which is actually really useful and has allowed me to achieve relatively good cable management over, like, in this setup. So all the monitor cables are nicely running behind the monitor stand there and are very well cable managed. And we have the monitor itself right here, which is of course curved. This monitor does also come with MSI's Mystic Light RGB lighting, but it has been implemented in this section right here. So once I turn the monitor on, I'll try to show you some of the RGB lighting effects, but bear in mind that these lighting effects are on the back of a monitor, and it's a little bit difficult for me to show you these lighting effects when the monitor is going to be facing the wall. Anyway, setting up the stand and everything is super easy. Simply slot this in here, drop it down, and then we need two screws right here to, of course, tighten this entire thing down. So you only need two screws right here, and it takes actually just a couple of seconds to get this up and running. So boom, just pop the screw into there, tighten it down, and there's the stand pretty much complete. All we got to do next is, of course, insert this and screw it in. Building this monitor and getting it up and running is very easy, and boom, we've built the stand, everything's all attached, and, you know, hopefully this won't just break on me. Nope, it's all good, man. So there's the monitor, all built, looking good, and as I mentioned a second ago, this stand is height adjustable and does have a little bit of a swivel, but this is about as much swivel as you can get out of the stand. The monitor is all ready to go. All that's left to do now is, of course, to remove the ultrawide monitor from the setup and replace it with this absolute beast from MSI. Now, will the PC still turn on? Right, that's a good sign. PC still boots. The fact that we finally actually have matching monitors that look the same makes me so freaking happy. Like, this actually looks so clean for once. Razer Synapse just turned on, and of course synchronized all of my Razer peripherals to all of the internals inside of the PC in terms of, like, LED lighting. Personally, I really like the look of this setup when everything is set to white, and there's, like, this nice contrast between black and white everywhere. I genuinely really like this color scheme. I feel like it looks so freaking clean. Alright, so it's been a couple days since I began recording this video, but hopefully you enjoyed watching that little Counter-Strike montage there. We ended up getting some pretty sick kills. And this monitor, let me talk a bit more about it, because the one here is my main display, you know, the one on the right. That one is actually running at 144Hz, not at 165, because we are using HDMI 2.0B, I think. And yeah, that's unfortunately capped at 18 gigabit per second, and you need a little bit more than that to actually push 165Hz on a 1440p panel. So just bear that in mind. But this one here, the one on the left, that one is running at 165Hz. AMD FreeSync is on for both of these monitors, and they are both pretty much like G-Sync compatible, at least from like my experience on two monitors. On an RTX 2060 that is inside there, I just hopped into the video control panel, enabled G-Sync for both of them, and I've had no problems. It pretty much just uses AMD FreeSync, but on your NVIDIA graphics card. And as for the refresh rate that it's actually rated at, I think it's like 48Hz up to 165, that's the FreeSync range. But overall, like, it's pretty damn good. No complaints on my end. Even at 144Hz, I should really like swap my main display to be running at 165 and my secondary one to be running at 144. But hey, you know, it's not that big of a difference, and I kind of don't mind too much. But maybe I just have to wait until Vivify finally released like an RGB DisplayPort cable. That is what we need, because then I can run an RGB DisplayPort cable for this one and for that one and just have a great time. Apart from gaming though, this monitor is pretty capable of like video editing and photo editing and everything else. Like, it's a pretty decent productivity monitor. It is only around £400. I say only, but it's actually pretty good value for money. You're getting 1 millisecond response time, Samsung VA panel, 165Hz, like, it's pretty damn good, and it's 1440p curved. There's a lot of good things to actually say about these monitors here. Like, they're genuinely good in terms of build quality, MSI Mystic Light. The overall on-screen display is like mega responsive, super easy to use, and you can like mess around with whatever settings you want. You can even enable an in-game overlay crosshair, and there's actually a bunch of different crosshairs to choose from, so we can swap it over to this one. I have tried using that crosshair whilst actually playing CSGO, because when you use an AVP on Counter-Strike, you actually lose your crosshair. But you can re-enable, you know, this cheeky crosshair overlay using your MSI monitor, which I actually found helps your accuracy when using an AVP. I'm not sure if anyone else has really experimented with enabling like a monitor crosshair overlay, but I've done it on this monitor and it's kind of useful. But the main problem I had with it is that there's no way to like adjust the actual size of the crosshair. Like, personally, I'd really like if the crosshair was legit just a dot, but they're pretty bold and they're pretty thick. So I'd kind of tend not to use it, because unless I'm scoped out, it's pretty much setting me at like a disadvantage, because I can't actually see like what I'm aiming at because the crosshair is like so goddamn thick. Ooh, and one more thing that this monitor has is a built-in headset holder, which is a little button right there that you press and then you can pull out, and you essentially have a place to hang your headset up. Now, this right here is like a Razer Nari Ultimate wireless, you know, battery-powered headset. And you would maybe think that once you hang this up on the monitor, it's gonna kind of cause the entire panel to, you know, maybe slant a certain way. But the monitor stand that MSI is using for these monitors is actually good. And, you know, the fact that there's a headset pretty much hanging on one side of the monitor doesn't seem to bother the monitor at all. It's just like upright, everything's all straight, there's no problems. Plus, you have like a really good spot to now hang your headphones up. Like, I low-key wanna hang my headphones up here instead of on my actual Razer Chroma headphone holder, because that one's a bit further away. So even if you have like a dual monitor setup using these monitors, just reaching over for your headset is like hella easy. And this is actually a feature that I had no idea was even a part of the monitor. And of course, the other monitor also has it, but we can't really put a headset in between two monitors, can we? But yeah, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Link in description down below to, of course, every single item featured in this setup, including, of course, MSI's monitors, the PC hardware, and, you know, everything else here as well will be linked down below in case you want to go buy it on Amazon. Also, you might have noticed these amazing Tech Block wallpapers. Look at this thing, man. This is dope as hell. And they're available in so many different colors to actually, like, suit your setup theme. So we can set one to pink. There's also a green. We have a blue. And let's not forget about the RGB version. There you go, RGB Tech Block wallpaper. Like, these are actually mad. They look so freaking good. And you know, they are available in many different colors, so you can kind of choose whatever you want and suit it to your own setup, of course, and to your own setup color scheme. But they are available exclusively for the Tech Block channel members. So if you want to go join the channel membership and get a bunch of perks, get a cool badge, shout out some videos, discounted merch, and over the next couple of months, I will be adding way more perks to all of the memberships. So they'll just get better and better as time goes on, and you'll get more stuff out of it, of course. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see all of you in another video soon. Goodbye.